So we now once again want to compare flow functions versus equations. So recall that we said MFP of F is equal to FK plus 1 top, and which is equal to FK top such that this condition is satisfied. The important question that we need to ask is what is this F in the above? Which flow function are we talking about? Is it a flow function of a node, a basic block? If yes, which basic block? So the point is our method computes the maximum fixed point of data flow equations. It means that this function f must be somehow related to the data flow equations. And that's the question that we want to ask. What's the relation between maximum fixed point of data flow equations and the maximum fixed point defined above? What is the relation between data flow equations and this function f that we are referring to above? So let's look at the data flow equations. Here, in1 is bi, out1 is f1 of in1. We can make all these functions take the entire vector of values. So we are working on a vector of values in1, out1, up to inn and out n. And this flow function can choose whatever it wishes to choose from these values. So for example, out1 can simply this flow function can simply apply f on in1 and ignore everything else. So this is how we can write our data flow equations. Now here all these new functions that we have written, they are of the form from a product lattice. This is a product lattice for all nodes. So this is L, this is L, this is L. So we have L cross L maps to L. So we have a flow function which takes an entire vector and gives us one value. But note that this value itself can be seen as an element in the vector. So we can rewrite this whole thing as this vector being computed. So this vector can be rewritten as this vector, where each flow function of this kind is a function from a vector to an element in the vector. And now we can rename this vector as something. Let's call this vector as x. Then this is x is equal to f1 of x, etc., etc., where x is this entire vector. Now we can even rewrite our flow function f of x as it's a function that works on a vector by applying different functions for each node to the vector. So we get this function x is equal to f of x, and this f is a flow function corresponding to the entire data flow equation. This is the equation. This is the equation whose fixed point we are computing, and this is the function whose fixed point we are computing. So we compute the fixed point of the function capital F or calligraphic F defined above. So let's try to visualize this. Let's try to illustrate this with an example. So again, we are back to a simple example. Here in1 is equal to 0, 0, out1 is equal to 1, 1, and in2 is equal to out1 meet out2, and out2 is equal to in2. We can rewrite the equation in this form that f of in1, out1, in2, out2 is 0, 0 because this is the value of in1, is 1, 1 because this is the value of out1, and the value of in2 is out1 meet out2, where out1 and out1 and out2 come from here, and the value of out2 is in2. So this is the equation in our form, and this is the function whose fixed point we are computing. So the maximum fixed point assignment is we start with all ones and we get 0. This is the maximum fixed point assignment. The minimum fixed point assignment is we start with all zeros and we get this value. Now we can plug in any initial value here and we will get the fixed point corresponding to that starting that initial value. So this is how we had generated several fixed point assignments in the previous lecture when we talked about different solutions of data flow analysis of this program, some of which were fixed point, some of which were maximum fixed point, one of which was maximum fixed point, one of which was minimum fixed point, and then there were two fixed points which are neither minimum nor maximum, and then there were some solutions which are not even fixed points. Those solutions were not computed using this, but all fixed point solutions over this example program can be computed using this. Now we want to understand the essential difference between MFP and MOP. Why is it that MOP is uncomputable but MFP can be computed? Observe that when we compute a fixed point, we define a fixed point. So we're talking about this program point U and program point V. We're saying the fixed point at V is a meet over all U's that are predecessors of V. We apply the flow function represented by this H FUV to the fixed point at U, and because FPV is a meet of all these, it clearly means that FPV is weaker than flow function applied to FPU. Does this relationship hold for MOP? The answer is no, and let us see why so. A short answer is MOPV is not computed from MOPU. Let me illustrate this with the help of a simple example. Here, this is a constant propagation example. A is 2, B is 3. Here, A is 3, B is 2. So, I have swapped the values. And initial value of C is 8 here. And initial value of C is 8 here. If we were to look at the MOP of U, the meet over all paths of U, so we have A is 2 here and 3 here, and therefore A is bottom here, B is 3 here and 2 here, so therefore B is bottom. However, C is 8 here and C is 8 here, therefore C is 8. So let's say this is our program point U, and we apply this flow function to compute the MOP of V. So if you compute, if you apply this flow function F to MOPU, which is bottom, bottom 8, this flow function will say, I will compute the value of C from the values of A and B in the input, and the values of A and B are bottom. So F applied to MOPU gives us bottom. However, it is easy to see that actual MOP solution is C's value is 5, because when we take this path, we find C is 5, and when we take this path, we find C is 5. So A and B are bottom, but C is 5. So this is sufficient to show that MOPV is not computed from MOPU. On the other hand, if we talk about fixed point solution, the fixed point solution at U is this, and F applied to fixed point solution gives us bottom, and the fixed point solution computed at V is also a bottom, saying that all A, B, C are non-constant. So FPV is certainly weaker than this because it is computed from FPU. So this is the basic difference between MOP and MFP. To summarize, MFP is computed inductively using edge-based specification. So if we have an edge like this, MFP at this is computed from MFP of this. However, MOP is a path-based solution. So MOP at this is not computed by MOP at this. The MOP of this and the MOP at this are independent. So let's once again look at the essential difference between MFP and MOP computation. Okay, when we have a meet semilattice satisfying DCC and monotonic flow functions, all our conditions are still same. MOPV is meet over all these paths reaching program point V, which is F rho 0, F rho 1, etc., etc. Whereas MFPV is meet over just computed from MFP of U. So MOPV exists because of descending chain condition. MOPV needs to iterate over all these paths reaching V, and that's the essential difference. MOPV need to iterate over all paths reaching V. The meet across all paths up to some PI may result in bottom value, after which we can ignore the paths. If that does not happen, then all paths reaching V should be exhausted. On the other hand, MFPV needs to iterate over entire CFG repeatedly. In each iteration of the graph, it needs to iterate over all predecessors. Termination depends on finding two successive values that are same. This is guaranteed by the descending chain condition and the monotonicity. So here is an example. Let's say we do constant propagation and we want to compute MOP. A is equal to 5 and here A is equal to 8. So we will get A is equal to 8, and then 8 and 5 will get bottom, but this will still be 8. Okay. So an algorithm to compute this solution needs to consider the path reaching 2, which is 1, then 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, etc. After how many paths should the algorithm say that I am going to get 8 and there is no path along which I am not going to get any value other than 8. I am not going to get bottom. Okay. So values being same across two successive paths cannot be the termination criterion for MOP, and we will not be able to decide how many paths we need to traverse, and therefore that is the intuitive reason why MOP is uncomputable. The last result that we wish to prove in this lecture is the soundness of FP, soundness of a fixed point solution. Recall that we have said that the meet over path solution is weaker than the abstraction function applied to all states reaching that program point, and therefore meet over path solution is sound. And now we want to prove that every fixed point is weaker than meet over path. We have proved that every fixed point is weaker than the maximum fixed point. But we want to prove that every fixed point is weaker than MOP, and therefore we'll end up proving that MFP is weaker than MOP, and therefore we'll end up proving that MFP is a sound assignment. So let's consider this situation where we have some node U and we have some node V. This path reaching U is denoted rho U. This path reaching V via U is denoted rho V. And now so the definition of MOPV is meet over all paths reaching V, F rho applied to BI. So our proof obligation is to show that for every path V, for an arbitrarily chosen path V that goes to V via U, FPV is weaker than F rho V applied to BI. If we did that, then we'll be able to argue that FP is weaker than MOP. So the first claim is FPV is weaker than FUV applied to FU. This is something that we have discussed in the previous slide. By the definition of fixed point computation, the value computed here will be weaker than this flow function applied to this value. So that's our claim number one. The proof outline is induction on the length of the path. The base case is length of path 0, which means that the program point that we're talking about is entry, and in any fixed point, because the data flow equations have said that the entry value of data flow value is BI and MOP is applied to BI, so therefore FP entry is equal to MOP entry is equal to BI, and therefore the base case holds. So inductive hypothesis is assume that it holds for path consisting of k edges, assume that it holds for the path reaching U, and now we show that it would hold for also the path reaching V. So what we're trying to say is that FPU is weaker than F rho U applied to BI, which is the inductive hypothesis. But from our claim 1, we also know that FPV is weaker than FUV applied to FPU. So we have FPU which is weaker than this, and FPV which is weaker than FPUV applied to FPU, which is weaker than F rho V applied to BI. So we substitute this value here and we get the implication that FPV is weaker than FUV applied to F rho U applied to BI, which means that we are applying this flow function F rho U, and to that we are applying this flow function. So we might as well compose these flow functions. So by composing these flow functions, we get FPV is weaker than this F rho V applied to BI. So we started with the fact that this holds for U, and we have shown that this holds for V as well. And this holds for every path, and this holds for every fixed point, and hence it holds for maximum fixed point as well. We didn't say anywhere that MFP is not a maximum fixed point. So which means that maximum fixed point is always weaker than MFP. In some cases it is strictly weaker, in some cases it is equal. In case of constant propagation, for some instances it is strictly weaker, and we have seen examples. For bit vector frameworks, because the flow functions are distributive, not just monotonic, MFP is equal to MOP. That's our next proof. MFP equal to MOP for distributive frameworks. And this proof is easy. We know that MOPV is equal to meet over all paths F rho applied to BI. Now we just take it out, we just take the predecessor out. We say, okay, instead we essentially are decomposing these paths in the paths reaching the predecessor and the flow function from the predecessor to V. So we pick up some arbitrary predecessor U, and we say we do this for every predecessor U, and then we say that for rho prime in paths reaching U, we have F UV applied to F rho V. So these two are identical. We have just split this path into a collection of these paths, and by distributivity we know that we can pull this FUV outside of the bracket. So we have FUV pulled outside of the bracket, which means that now if you look at this definition, it's easy to see that this is MOPU, which means that MOPV is defined inductively in terms of MOPU if the flow function F is distributive. Now we are saying here that MOP is a fixed point when the flow functions are distributive, because this is how we compute a fixed point. Okay, so now we say that for all V, MOPV is weaker than MFPV, and MOPV is stronger than MFPV by the solution of MFP, which means that MFPV must be equal to MOPV when the flow functions are distributed. Okay, so that's the proof that for distributive data flow frameworks, MOP is same as MFP, implying for distributive data flow frameworks, static analysis is decidable. It is undecidable only when the flow functions are non-deterministic, assuming of course that we have a meet semi-lattice satisfying descending chain condition. That completes this part of the lecture. In the next part of the lecture, we will look at the algorithms, we will look at formal definition of the algorithms for computing the solutions that we have talked about in this lecture.